Hello everybody, welcome to MELAG Hygiene World and our today's webinar Infection Control, Introduction and Requirements. My name is Sören Staffi, I'm responsible for a few export markets and have the pleasure to hold a webinar with you today, and we might discuss some issues regarding infection control. So far we can say discuss, but you have the possibility to write in our panel questions, and we try to give you an answer online as soon as we can. And afterwards, you can also send emails if you have further, more detailed question, and we will try to answer as good as we can to that subject. All right, Hygiene World, infection control. It's a very important matter in more and more clinics and more regions worldwide. And we have to discuss, we have to know some details as a good preparation for our patients' safety and our patients' health. If you speak about the next folio is a little bit blocking. If you speak about hygiene and infection control, we have to distinguish between the different areas and medical facilities. As you know, MELAG is a experienced and very competent company for smaller facilities, for system solution in small hospitals and private clinics and dental medical ordinances. And so far we do not have the focus to a central sterilization device, a supply department. Of course, the rules and the requirements are similar, but the conditions are different. And that's a quite important difference to that different areas. The central sterilization supply department is always focused to a lot of instruments, to packing lists, to a proper detailed documentation, and much higher quality management system as we can expect in smaller medical facilities. And therefore, today we just have time to explain and discuss the requirements in smaller medical facilities. And if we can solve questions, if we can solve problems here, we have reached a lot of things. Our conditions mostly are not the sterile environment inside the treatment room. If you imagine you go to a dentist or to a medical doctor or a smaller treatment center, we cannot find sterile treatment rooms. We just find standard rooms, standard conditions, but important is to have sterile instruments, processed, reprocessed instruments in a high level in order to ensure the patient safety on best situation we can deliver. And therefore we have to follow different rules. And you should know that, you should inform your clients in order to transfer that knowledge to all the facilities. It's quite simple to arrange. It's not a big problem of investment, just mostly the point of a proper arrangement, of proper knowledge, and following the different rules and expectations. Basically, we have to say that medical instruments, or the instruments we use in medical facilities, are medical instruments and have to follow some legal procedures, some legal conditions, guidelines, standards. And so far the legal situation is different to normal rules in household or whatever some users think about cleaning and eventually disinfection of instruments. So far that is an extremely focused subject under different legal conditions. So in the most countries, we do have a medical law and have to follow the details. The other point is that we do have microorganisms here. Infections are based on influence of microorganisms, and microorganisms are quite small. They are too small in order to see them, to determine them, to have an opinion whether they are pathogen or healthy for the for our body, for nutrition, whatever. So far, we have to assume that all instruments we use in a medical treatment are infectious. And therefore we have to handle the entire instrument reprocessing on same on high level in order to bring a result of sterile instruments back to the patients. And the slogan for infection control for instrument processing in our environments means avoiding of cross-contamination. We have to block the transfer ways between all the different parties involved in using medical instruments. Those are the patients, those are the nurses, those are the doctors, those are eventually assistants, and all of them are bringer or receiver of microorganisms into the process of instrument handling. And so far, the value is to avoid the cross-contamination between all those parties. And finally, infection control is also a key of marketing for clinics, since all the different clinics stay in the competition, we can say. So they are not lonely in the market. They have neighbors, they have competitors on the street, have competitors with the public sector, with hospitals and clinics. And so far, the primary infection control is also a marketing role. And nowadays, of course, we use internet. We get a good information which treatment the clinic offers, and which qualification the doctors, the operators do have. But also we should have the information about the hygiene level, about the hygiene developed and processed in that clinic. How does it look? What kind of equipment do they use? And what is the procedure in order to bring the highest protection for me as patient, and for you, of course, as eventually patient or consultant of the clinic. So if you speak about the different microorganisms, we can go in details and see bacteria, we can see enzymes, we can see protozoans, we can see fungi, we can see spores, all those things. But actually, we do not need the knowledge about the details and plus and minus, pro and cons about the microorganisms. As I said before, they're actually too small in order to have any essential information. We have to assume the infective risk and bring all the instrument on a good level, on the sterile level, or on the highly disinfected level in order to allow a proper treatment and a non-risky treatment for our patients. So far, I would like to cut that information here. There are plenty of books regarding microbiology, but in the end, it doesn't help us in our daily role. We have to see the results and the prevention in order to get a proper hygiene cycle arranged. And for the understanding and for the arrangement of our hygiene cycle, of our infection control understanding, of course, we have to see which ways of infection we can inspect. And so far, if you see a standard dental clinic, we see for one side the airborne droplet infection. If you use spray systems like handpieces or like spray pistons in order to rinse something, to clean something, there are a lot of aerosol buildings, a lot of microorganisms in the air around the users, the nurses and doctors, but also around the patient. And there is no possibility to separate the way or to distinguish between the good and the bad boys. We have to make clear, we have to ensure that we do not get any of those microorganisms and have to protect ourselves as best as we can. One side is wearing, and we do not mention it in that in that presentation in detail. But it's also a point of hygiene, of basic hygiene, understanding that we protect ourselves with the normal medical clothes, with the gloves, and with all the mask we can have in order to follow the basic rules. Here we just speak about instrument processing, about the background information, but we have to respect and we have to follow also the other standard basic hygiene rules. That is quite logic. Or if you see the water related infection possibilities, the smear infection, all the surfaces, all the tubes and instruments we use as assistants, we have to disinfect, we have to sterilize as far as we can do it. Surfaces, of course, have to be cleaned and disinfected regularly. So that is a standard procedure handled by different explanations. And we do have also a webinar for our disinfectants, Melades, so we can refer to that in order to give you more information regarding that basic hygiene information. And if you have a further look to the ways of infection in different treatments and different medical areas, we see possibilities by the blood transfer by salvia. Different diseases are connected with different ways of transmission, and all those ways, the droplet, the water-related transmission, also a direct contact with the organs, with the mucosal membrane, with some skin pathogen, or even a healthy area. So we have to expect that a lot of diseases can be transferred also in the ambulant medical areas, not only in hospitals. Of course, we know the high risk to get infection in hospitals. We know also high level of hygiene standard in hospitals, but that, for instance, multi-resistance diseases is a different subject, a different presentation maybe for that subject. But here we speak about the ambulant, mostly ambulant medical facilities, the smaller hospitals, the smaller clinics. And also here we have a lot of risky infective ways. So therefore, the medical device processing is determined, as said before, as assuming medical instruments are highly infected, and we have to do all the different measures, we have to follow the rules in order to bring them on a clean, disinfected, and sterile status. And the matter of maintenance is also important. What happens with instruments? How to bring instruments in the way to bring their function, to fulfill all the performance they are made for. And therefore, the inspection, the checking of instruments is a part of the anti-infection control system, of the anti-infection control circle, in order to have not just sterile instrument or disinfective instruments. We need also well-working instruments and proper instruments for doing the treatment job. And that is really a part of the entire system, and determined by values as well. We have to keep the value of the instruments. You know, medical instruments are rather expensive, and that value has to be maintained. That is also an important matter in the subject. And if you speak about standards, if you speak about guidelines for medical instruments as part of a medical law in all the different countries, we have to refer to detailed standards for instruments, for the entire processing area, for devices, for appliances. There are always, you can expect a lot of national, or here we can say European, guidelines. In other countries and other areas of the world, there are some other local standards or standards in process, because we see working groups worldwide trying to adopt their standards to each other in order to create an ISO, a worldwide valid standard for different subjects. So we see on one hand different standard numbers, but in the end standards who try to fulfill similar requirements or to set up a similar standard in order to ensure, for instance, patient safety or the validity of well working instruments and devices. Here we see just a short selection for sterilization of products, for the appliances of sterilization, of disinfection and cleaning machines. We do have standards for packing, for sealing devices and all those things. All details are regulated, and the user, the owner of the cleaning, have to ensure that all those requirements are fulfilled. And you as dealer, we as manufacturer, we will deliver all the information for the user in order to have it relatively easy to follow the things. And therefore, a system solution by a manufacturer is always a good solution in order to have one competent partner, in order to have all the details packed in one system and bring a proved result following the national or worldwide standards. So the green arrow went away. One short information, one short hint to terms, what we usually discuss and what usually users mix up. For instance, here the term is disinfection and sterilization. We have to be aware that the entire cycle of instrument processing is a sequence. One hint, of course, is to follow step by step to the following step. The other is to respect the different definitions and functions in that cycle. So that means that disinfection is a different story from sterilization. And disinfection is necessary to get sterile products. On the other hand, sometimes disinfection is the highest level because things cannot be sterilized, like walls or floors. But all those things, all instruments, all supporting things for our medical doing should be sterilized. Sterilization is the highest level of disinfection, so we can say, but sterilization is also a much higher reduction of aggressive of pathogen microorganisms, and sterilization is the only possibility to kill the spores, the living, the next generation of microorganisms. Disinfection is just a reduction by 10 to minus 5, 1 to 10,000. And disinfection mostly blocks the ability to bring a further infection, but it doesn't kill the microorganism. Sterilization is the overkill. Sterilization includes the killing of spores and brings really here a clear sterile condition situation. And if you see rates, we have to say that sterilization is a result of 1 to 1 million microorganisms. So if you have the view to the entire hygiene cycle, to the reprocessing cycle, and I said about the sequence of steps, everything of course starts with a treatment, in a special room. In the best case is an operating theater, but we often see the standard rooms, the normal rooms, we call a treatment room. And here the used instruments have to be brought to another area, to a different area where the instruments are reprocessed. So the things, the sequence starts with the transportation in a protected case, in a protected condition, that those infectious instruments cannot do reinfect, cannot spread any microorganisms to other areas, to other persons, to other instruments via transportation. So that has to be happen on a protective way. And then it will come to the place where the instruments are stored for the first step of cleaning, eventually pre-cleaning of instruments. And cleaning is a very, very important sequence, an important step in that entire cycle. If you have now cleaning, if you have now reduction of all the bioburden, we cannot expect a proper disinfection and sterilization result. So cleaning is important, and therefore the international standard is going on to demand the automized cleaning, the use of washer disinfectors in order to have a proper solution. Alternatively, we speak also about the manual cleaning, the manual disinfection in a bath with chemical agents. But here we, of course, have a lot of risks and also malfunctions done by the personnel. It doesn't mean that all the staff, all the users produce a lot of mistakes every day, but the human factor is in any case a weak factor, and so malfunctions are higher possible than we use in a machine, than we use an automated procedure, and we use a validated procedure. So that word of validation, of validated procedure, will be in our doing more and more, not only in medical products, but especially also for medical products, in order to ensure a proper processing of instruments. Without a validated and reproducible processing, we cannot expect the same results as we have to get. And so far, the point of validation will reach us more and more, demanded by government, demanded by guidelines, in order to make a high quality system, high quality result after our processing. So the next step after cleaning, of course, is inspection. Was there any defect? Was there any problem? Did the machine or did the personnel before make everything wrong, everything okay? Or do we see any things we have to repeat? So far, inspection is a very important matter, but also inspection in the main, in the view of maintenance, to see do we have any defect at our instrument, any complicated situation, do we have to send it to repair or to a special maintenance procedure, or can we proceed, can we fulfill our line with the next step, and that would be the packing as far as we do it, but mostly instruments before sterilization should be packed in different possibilities. We will see that a little bit later. And then the most important step here is a sterilization cycle in order to ensure sterile instrument. Afterwards, it has to be stored somewhere under sterile conditions or in a room which is designed as sterilization storage room in order to hold all the finalized, the sterilized, the reprocessed instrument for further use. And then we will go back to the treatment room. Here there is also a certain logistic necessary. Instrument sets are more and more popular in order to have a fixed arrangement of instruments for different treatments. If you see that here in a so-called one room concept, we see the flow from dirty area to the sterile area. We now also from let's say bigger clinics, from clinics who work in the way of central sterilization department, that they use a second room, a third room, or even a fifth room in order to fulfill all the different steps of instrument reprocessing. But we see also that a well-arranged, a well-planned one room is also enough to proceed with a proper instrument reprocessing sequence. Yeah, we do have the place for bringing in the instrument. We have eventually a sink for pre-cleaning. We have a washer disinfector for the cleaning, disinfection, and also drying. Here we see the Miller Therm machine. We do have an inspection place. We have a packing station with here Miller Seal 200. We know alternatively also the 100, the bar sealing device, or the Miller Seal Pro. We do have a sterilizer here as a new evolution version, and also the documentation line. It can be done by a book primitively, or it can be done by a software here, Miller Trace used. So far we have all the information, we have the flow, and finally we can say here at the end we have well prepared sterile instruments for proper next treatment. If you see it in a line, why not? It shouldn't be a complete room in a round sequence. It could be also a line from the left to the right. We can place all the different steps here, and you see the entire width is 3.20 meters. So that's approximately the space we need. It could be eventually a little bit smaller, but even longer. But here on compact area and compact size, we also can process a high level instrument reprocessing with all the needed steps without any big room. Then we see in a lot of facilities, there is no extra room. There is no big space for instrument reprocessing. We have to live with conditions. The requirements go further. The authorizations, the institutions, they demand more and more and more, but the rooms do not grow. So we have to adapt our higher level of expectation to existing facilities. And as I said before, with a clever planning, with a good consultation by dealers, with experienced information, we can set up a proper line of instrument processing also in a smaller shelf line, let's say, or in a smaller room. So that is not the biggest problem. The biggest problem is to have no knowledge about the ways and cross over all the different stations and bring a cross-contamination inside our processing room. By good knowledge, by good arrangement, we can avoid that. So that's quite simple. Here we see some pictures from planning station on top view. See here we have a square room, can arrange all the different things from left to the right, or in a corner situation. Beneath we see it in a live view, how it's arranged in a small dental clinic, nicely with two sterilizers, with a Miller Therm washer disinfector, and all the documentation system. So the practical view does not show a big area. So we really can do it on small surfaces, on small areas, but with highly integrated, with high results. One more detailed, it doesn't look very interesting to see such a list, such a information, but here I would like to give you a small background, a small hint, what has to be discussed for the entire planning of infection control system. And if you speak about different instruments, if you speak about treatments, if you speak about different use, we have to wonder how do we use the same instrument and what is a way of processing. And naturally, we would say if we buy an instrument from manufacturer X, Y, Z, then they shall give us the instruction how to reprocess that instrument, or isn't this a reprocessing allowed? Whatever. So far, we have to wonder the setup of instruments, the analysis, how we use it. Is it an invasive invasive treatment? Is it a non-invasive treatment? Are there special conditions required? How to process the instrument, or can we do it somehow flexible. And so far, that setup, that risk analysis, and here it's aligned by Robert Koch Institute here in Germany, the former health care institute for Germany. They made some basic recommendation, some basic information, how to select, how to distinguish between the different instruments and use. And the basic rule is that we say what kind of instruments we have and how we use it. So, and answering those questions, we find the way how to process. Sometimes the manufacturers of instruments, they give us some hints, sometimes not. And we as, let's say, as user, as owner of a clinic, we have to set up our own rule. We have to set up the circle of instruments reprocessing, because the owners of the clinic are responsible. They have a legal responsibility against their patients and have to carry all the responsibilities. So far, they have to make a decision how to process it. If the manufacturer or anybody else fails, it's not that legal responsibility. The owner, the person who do the who does the treatment, they're in a responsibility to deal with the consequences. So far, the most simple, the most basic instruments are the non-invasive, the non-critical instruments, like, for instance, ECG electrodes, which are just put on the skin, mostly on the healthy skin of our patients. And often it's used as one way, quite sure, but there are also indications using other electrodes, other sondes for maybe more complicated diagnostic machines. But those instruments should be disinfected, and the things are rather clear. If you see instruments which touch the body, which touch organs, which touch some inner organs of our body, it is a little bit more complicated. So we distinguish between the semi-critical instruments and the critical instruments. And we have to distinguish between a hollow and a solid instrument. So there are different degrees, and depending on the setup of semi-critical instruments, for instance, then we can say, okay, a disinfection, of course, is recommended. We have to do a disinfection. A sterilization would be nice, would be bring the instrument on a safe level, but it's not demanded, it's not required. But for all the invasive used instruments, the critical instruments, therefore we have to perform the entire cycle. We have to do a proper cleaning, a pre-cleaning, we have to do the disinfection, and we have to do the sterilization. And here the steam sterilization, of course, is the matter of the time, state of the art, because that procedure has a lot of advantages, which we cannot discuss here. The time is too short. And here we can refer to other webinars we offer, which you will find on our YouTube channel, or which you will find on our live webinar sessions. If you look to melac.com, you will find always the schedule for the different webinars, and you can check, you can see what is in your focus, and you can apply and follow those webinars, or check it out in our YouTube channel. So, but important here is to follow the recommendation to perform the steam sterilization, and eventually if you have some very special instruments which needs much higher a level of infection control, then we have to eventually follow other steps. But in our facilities, in our medical ambulant facilities, mostly we do not deal with neurosurgery and so on. So that is determined, that is designed for hospital operating theaters under special conditions, and they have their CSSD procedures in order to respect those higher demands. The same is for Creutzfeldt-Jakob diseases and so on. So those are very special cases, very seldom cases. Here normally we speak about the majority of normal instrument processing handling. First step, just to give you some pictures, some ideas. First step for infection control cycle, hygiene cycle is the washer disinfector here, the Miller-Serm, with the different baskets, with the different features. Also here we offer, and I refer more and more to other webinars than to ours here, we refer to a special information regarding washer disinfector and all the available accessories. That is a quite different subject, just you have seen here, the possibility for a compact volume for compact processing in smaller facilities. Also for hollow instruments and special instruments, tubes, endoscopes, channels, and so on. The packing station here for the inspection place, we don't need any special appliances. A magnifier lamp is enough, therefore here no picture, but for the packing station, we know the more or less simple bar sealing devices, which are also cheaper, but also available with a validated cycle, with a control of all the parameters, a documentation interface, in order to fulfill demands for electronic documentation or validated packing sealing cycles. We do have the rotary sealer, Miller Seal Pro, for instance, in order to fulfill higher needs, higher amount of packed instruments. In different markets, we have many, many packed instruments in each treatment cycle. So far, a powerful rotary sealer is much easier, much more effective than a bar sealer, which is normally designed for not that often used packing procedures, or for clients who, for instance, perform with a cassette system, for instance, with a Miller Store system, to put all the instruments already in a washing tray, to put the washing tray in a washer disinfector, and bringing it in the same condition to the inspection place, to the sterilization place, just closing in a sterilization container. Very effective way, quite popular in ways for smaller treatment. Or we know it, of course, from the hospital, from the CSSD procedure. Here, all the operating theater sessions will be supplied by containers, by treatment setups. And so far for our environment, such an instrument sets are also more and more popular and very effective, cost saving, and of course time saving, and protective for the users, because we do not need to touch the instruments again and again. And you know, those instruments often are very sharp or have a small tip which can be damaged, and so on. So that the placing and packing in such a washing tray cassette system is a very effective way for instrument handling and ensuring a proper instrument processing system with a certain quality management system as well in the background. Some pictures of loadings inside the autoclave. You see often the combination between different packing situations, between different instruments, following the next treatment needs or following the day schedule. So there is no standard. We have to fulfill the needs, and we have to select the right appliances, the right needs for our instrument which we use in the clinic. So there is no standard setup for all, let's say, dental or ophthalmological treatments. We have to see it really clinic by clinic, depending on the patients, depending on various treatments, and so far it's always very individual. Also the use of the proper sterilizer, mostly we speak about the different classes. We speak about more and more B-class sterilizers following the European standard. But also here we refer to a special webinar, to special information, since the matter of sterilization is also diversified, and there is some background knowledge necessary. What kind of good sterilizer can I recommend to that clinic or to the different clinic, depending on patients, depending on treatments? Always the same questions. And we have to plan, we have to consult our clients for the right decision. So the time of sterilization, of cycle time of sterilization is important. The drying results are important, the documentation needs, and so on. So first of all, a questionnaire, consultation session with our users, with our clinics is necessary in order to select the right product and the right setup of different machines, of different appliances. So we cannot use just one for everything and everybody. So we have to discuss it and find the best solution. And there's also a consultation about a processing for the next 10, 15 years. Yeah, so it's a professional tool and it has to work every day. It has to have a certain quality in order to fulfill all the stressed needs in a medical facility daily. We do not want to have breakdowns. We do not want to have trouble and costs for repairs and problems and sending patients home because there are no instruments available and so on. We need a well-working background. We need well-prepared instruments for a trouble-free treatment and supply of a good healthcare for our patients. And even so, the doctors, the owners of clinics often do not use hygiene, do not use infection control systems personally. Is necessary, is worth doing the right job, having the right machines, having the good concept in order to process, to perform the treatment as well on the highest level. And more clinics came to that point and let's say market their infection control cycle to show the patient how it works, what investment they have done for the patients in order to show them the safety in the clinic and finally trouble-free situation for the patient as well. Finally, we can say we can have the best appliance, the best setup, the best procedure, but we need also a certain control. If you speak about validated cycle, if you speak about high quality appliances, starting with washer disinfectors, sealing machines, autoclaves, we know they perform every day in the same way, every year in the same way, and the result of sterilization, for instance, will be the same after 10 years. But authorities often demand an independent check of successful processing result or sterilization result. And so far there are different indicator systems, different process channel devices in order to show an independent evidence. In former years, we used biological systems, spores, and have them sent to a biological institute to check. It took a long time, and between that checking time, nothing was checked and controlled so far. Nobody knew what happened with the processing area, but there was also no interest to check that. But following the daily demands, following the higher level of infection control system, the authorities demand a cycle check, for instance, by chemical indicator systems, for instance, by process challenging devices. And so far we know the Miller control system, for instance, the so-called Helix systems, we know some indicator stripes in order to bring in immediate evidence of a successful cycle. There's still a discussion about indicator systems for washer disinfectors. It's not finished, so we cannot make any recommendation or opinion here for that matter, because there are too many influences, too many impacts available. But for the sterilization, for instance, there those Helix systems are well known and quite often used as independent source for a safe sterilization result. And finally, we can wonder how we can document what we do. We can say we have nice appliances, and we show the results after sterilization, and we assume everything was okay. But more and more authorities demand a complete documentation cycle, and documentation is also part of a validated cycle. Then we do not have any file or printout, even so we have proper working devices. If you have no proper documentation on paper base or on digital base, but of course a digital base using a software with an interactive link to implemented machines, to implemented washer disinfectors, sealing machines and autoclaves, for instance. Without that proper software, I cannot have a detailed and quick documentation. We have to see that we perform thousands of cycles yearly, and the appropriate cycle if somebody asks for what happened 4 months ago in case of that treatment of that patient. It is very, very difficult to go in the archive and search all the different folders and paper blocks and whatever. So far, a software is more effective, of course. And the use should be quite easy, quite simple. MilaTrace is a good example for a documentation software, completely designed for a smaller processing cycle and completely designed for interactive activity with the MILAC appliances. So far, a few clicks and I can have my proper result, and also create a protocol, a PDF, for instance, have an easy archive function or to find protocols. We can use barcodes in order to identify instruments, in order to identify cassettes, in order to identify special loads. And so we can ensure a certain tracking function as well. But depending on the legal requirements, we have a need or we have no need for a software for a documentation, but we can assume documentation will be part of the infection control system in all medical facility within the next years. It will start with a paper with a few indicator documentations, but finally with a complete software file. So here, for instance, really the definitely clinic-wise used instruments, setups, trace systems can be shown in the software and tracked by MilaTrace. Finally, maybe you have a question. If not, it would be also nice. But you can have a review to that webinar, to all webinars in our YouTube channel, MELAC Medizintechnik. You'll find a lot of information in different languages to all the different subjects, to our products. You will find some tutorials. You will find the more and more specific webinars to different subjects, what we notice in the market, what is necessary, what our dealers demand from the market. So we are online to bring more and more content into our channels in order to give you a good platform for education. And we'd like to ask you to use it also for your presentations, for your discussions with your clients, in order to show them the contents, the knowledge of you as dealer, but also the knowledge of us as a manufacturer. We're doing that job for more than 60 years and seem to know what we do and how are the difficulties, the details in that field. Sometimes it sounds quite simple, but if you look into the questions, you will find a lot of unclarified details, and we can bring some transparency. We can help you to find the answer, the specific answer for the specific question by our clients, of course. So Feel free to send questions, to have all your comments. We are also happy to get your feedback, to get your needs, to have further ideas to further webinars. We do not want to bring the webinars just for doing that here. We would like to answer your question. We would like to research on new questions for the field in order to have a better situation in clinics, in medical dental offices, to ensure the patient safety more and more, because it's the health of us all. And we wish you good luck, and thank you very much for your attention and your patience, and best regards to all of you.